In the heart of New Delhi's bustling, crowded Connaught Place stands Dhoomimal Art Gallery. It is not just a place for displaying, buying and selling art, the usual activities associated with an art gallery. For the last 70 years, it has also been a meeting place for artists and a place for discovering and nurturing young talent. Dhoomimal Art Gallery had a fortuitous beginning. It started in 1936 as Dhoomimal Dharamdas at 8A Connaught Place as a high-quality printing and stationery shop. One of the items it specialized in was the printing of greeting cards with Indian motifs and images. The search for original Indian images brought Dhoomimal Dharamdas in contact with the Indian artists. A young scion of the distinguished Jain family that owned this shop soon realized that there was hardly any place in Delhi where the artists could buy art materials. And thus, Dhoomimal Dharamdas started keeping art materials primarily for helping the artists, rather than as a viable business line.
What are your earliest memories of Dhoomimal Art Gallery?
My mother was, apart from being a Hindi writer and musician, she also painted. And I would sort of trips along to this nearest and probably only place where you could find artist material in a block.
I think it grew out of the stationery shop because artists had to come and buy their stuff here. It evolved into a talking place, an adda of artists.
The young man who had come up with the idea of keeping art materials at the stationery shop was Ramchandra. He was then hardly 20 years old. He had an instinctive fascination for art and the company of artists, who used to affectionately call him Ram Babu. Ram Babu's earliest known ancestor, Seth Dhoomimal, had settled down in Chandni Chowk of Old Delhi around 1860. In the aftermath of the Great Revolt of 1857, a lot of noblemen, artisans, poets and musicians associated with the Mughal court had fled Delhi. They had left behind their beautiful havelis and stately mansions. Seth Dhoomimal acquired a haveli from one of the court musicians. Over the next few decades, the presence of the family in Chandni Chowk became so dominant that a whole street came to be known as Katra Dhoomimal, after one of the famous successors of Mathura Das. Later generations of Seth Dhoomimal diversified into making of traditional ledgers, trading in paper and printing business. Branches of the family are still engaged in the printing business. Ram Babu was perhaps the first person in the family to combine his interest in art with a traditional family business. Ram Babu's passion for art took him on a journey that was unusual, if not altogether crazy, at a time when contemporary Indian art had little or no market. He soon became friends with some of the best-known artists of his time, such as Jamini Roy, A.R. Chugtai, D. Badri, Nicholas Rorick, Sushil Sarkar. In the circle of Ram Babu's artist friends, Silos Mukherjee had a special place. A gifted artist and a true bohemian, Silos had studied art in Calcutta College of Art as well as in Holland and had struck his own path away from the dominant Bengal school. He had given up a secure job as art director with the Imperial Tobacco Company to lead the life of an artist. In Delhi, Art College, where he shaped the sensibility of a whole generation of painters, even Ram Babu, who had never gone to an art college, became a reasonably competent painter under his guidance. By temperament, Silos Mukherjee was warm, unpredictable, volatile, irreverent, and indifferent to money. In sharp contrast, Ram Babu was gentle, affectionate, a good host, and had genuine respect for artists. Strangely, despite the differences in their temperaments, they still shared a close relationship.
But do you realize at that point of time, it was not just the need for buying material here, you needed some more solid support. And this could only have come because this is the only venue, I mean, the only establishment, Ram Babu, which was in sight. I don't think there was any other. So Ram Babu just came in sort of handy.
There is no doubt that Silos Mukherjee was a very original and distinguished artist. However, it is also a fact that Ram Babu played a crucial role in establishing him in Delhi.